within your study of law and study of how Washington dovetails with new technology, is this just a question of Washington and our federal law not knowing how to deal with just the barriers being blown apart by modern technology?
Oh, I don't think so. I mean, you know, this is, you know, this was, putting aside the Department of Justice's action, this is Judge Denise Coate, who is a very, very widely respected judge, very experienced, very smart. You know, she wrote a very detailed opinion, 160 pages.
She's not an oddball.
She's not an oddball by any means. And, you know, and this is a pretty, you know, very detailed written opinion, very detailed findings of fact. There was no jury in this trial. The judge served as the finder of fact. And, you know, when Judge Coate finds this, and you know, it's interesting, going to your point, you know, she made adverse credibility findings against some serious people, including Q, you know, which is another way of kind of saying, it's a nice way of saying that, like, I think they lied.
Jargon alert here, what is an adverse credibility issue?
Essentially, it means the judge basically saying, I didn't believe this witness. I don't think this witness was telling me the truth when they testified at trial. And look, that's kind of a big deal for a senior executive, for a finder of fact to say, it's not just that, hey, I believe what you're saying, but you're wrong on the law. It was, I don't think you were presenting accurate facts to the jury.
Well, this certainly has implications for how tech companies negotiate content deals in the future. But for Apple, it doesn't really make that much of a difference. The irony here is that Apple only gets about 10% of its sales from iTunes, which is how its books are sold. So this is immaterial to its
bottom line. But it is going to have to negotiate with, as it pursues Apple Television, it's going to have to negotiate with some of the networks and the content providers there.
And I think very importantly, potentially the Department of Justice looking over its shoulder.
Yeah.
When it goes to damages, now the Department of Justice, the federal government isn't looking for monetary damages. That's the 33 states that have joined in that will be looking to impose penalties on Apple to compensate for what consumers lost. Department of Justice is looking for injunctive relief, and that includes potentially how Apple negotiates further deals, right, whether they can use most favored nation statuses again in their future contracts.
20 seconds, Jason Trenner, buy Apple, buy Amazon?
I'm a buyer of Apple.
Maybe. I own the stock.
I really
don't. I have no idea
what Neil is saying.
But as an Apple investor, legal headaches are a challenge.
It's a challenge, but the stock is trading at 10 times earnings and has a 3% yield. I also say that it issued bonds in May, probably at the low.
That was crystal clear.
I mean, so
adverse injunctive.
Yeah. Adverse credibility. Lying.
Lying.